Good evening, Skippers fans, and welcome to the Boatyard here at Historic Holmes Field for tonight's game with your River City Skippers hosting the High Point Hushpuppies. Your Skippers come into tonight's game at 8-7, trying to break a two-game losing streak. Let's see if they can pull that off tonight as they host the Hushpuppies from High Point. On the mound tonight for the Skippers is number 17, Peyton Wagner. Let's see if the Skippers and Coach Noah Cartwright can overcome this losing streak that they've been on as of late and get back into the win column. Leading off for the Hushpuppies is number 12, Carter Bass. Let's see if Peyton Wagner can get us started off. And the pitch. And Bass files one back to the fence. Wagner gets his sign and gets set. Evens the count at one. The 1-1 pitch, a little surprising. Got him right inside. So that's going to make it 1-2 as you count. Bass pops one to shortstop and is easily handled for out number one.
Now batting number 13, J.R. Langerfeldt.
Next up for the Hushpuppies is number 13, Langerfeldt. Takes first pitch is a strike. Wagner with the wind up. A little bit on the outside, ball one. And Wagner with the pitch. Hopper into towards second base. Easily handled for out number two. That's going to bring up number 19, Christian Walker, for the Hushpuppies. Walker, their designated hitter for this evening. See how Wagner handles Walker at the plate. Walker hits a dribbler to second. Easily taken care of by Drew Nagel. And that's going to end the first inning. All right, Skipper fans, going into the bottom of the first. Going to lead off with number 8, Cole Wagner. Wagner comes to the plate with a 189 average. Let's see if he can improve on that this evening. He takes first pitch and rockets it into left field. And it is called foul, so that's going to bring Wagner back up to the plate. Bryce England is pitcher for the Hushpuppies. Getting set, getting his signs. And the pitch. It's going to even the count at 1 to Wagner. The 1-1 pitch, a little low. England in the stretch. Way outside. 3 balls and a strike. And England from off the hill throws in ball 4 and is going to put Wagner on first. That's going to bring up Kobe Ott. Kobe Ott coming into tonight's game, batting 345 on the summer season. And Ott pops one high and out of play on the first base line. England with the 0-1 pitch. Catches Ott swinging. Wagner takes his lead from first and is driven back by England. angling in the stretch, is gonna make contact with Ott, and that's gonna send Ott trotting to first. And that's gonna bring up number 18, Drew Nagel. Correction on my part, ladies and gentlemen. Nagel, a freshman out of Frisco, Texas, currently attends High Point University. And he watches strike one come down from the mound. Runners on first and second, no outs. Bottom of the first for the Skippers. England gets his sign, checks his runners. And the windup, little outside, evens the count at one. As the rain starts to fall here at Holmes Field, still have some diehard baseball fans here in the stands for what we're hoping is going to be a Skipper's win this evening. And runners advance to second and third, respectively. Two, one is your count. Nagel gets set. Pops one up. And it's going to be out of play, first base line. England gets his sign in the stretch. Outside, ball three. That's gonna bring full count for Nagel at the plate. The 3-2 pitch. Popped into towards left field, but is easily handled by number 12, Carter Bass, for the Hushpuppies. That's going to bring up Ryan Bellamy, number 37, for the Skippers. Let's see if Ryan has any luck against England this evening as we start off. First pitch is a little low. Bellamy sends one screaming into center field, but is handled by Drake Carrick. But with it, it brings in Cole Wagner for the score. Let's put your Skippers up 1-0. That's going to bring up Jaden Greenidge, number 24 for your Skippers, a freshman out of Richmond, Virginia, currently attending Lincoln University. Jaden sends one into right field. It's going to be handled pretty nonchalantly by Logan Dolph to end the inning. Thank you. And here we go, Skipper's fans, going into the top of the second. Hushpuppies have number 42, Eli Willing, coming to the plate. Wagner gets his sign on the mound. And the pitch. Willen sends one into right field. Where Paxton Huff comes over to assist and make the play for out number one.
Now batting number 37, Caden Swain.
That's going to bring Caden Swain to the plate for the Hushpuppies. First baseman. Hushpuppies come into tonight's game with a record of 6-10. Court Keegley made the play there in right field on that last bat. And quickly the Hushpuppies are two outs at the top of the second. Rain continuing to fall here at Holmes Field, and that's going to be popped up. Cole Wagner made an attempt to make the play on the ball, but was thwarted in his attempt by the wet grass here at Holmes Field. That's going to bring up Logan Sawyer for the Hushpuppies. And Wagner's going to make contact with Sawyer on the elbow there with that last pitch. It's going to send him trotting to first. Two outs on the Hushpuppies, runners on first and second. It's going to bring up Cody Donnell for the Hushpuppies. Wagner gets his sign and checks his runners. And the pitch. And Donnell watches it fly by for strike one. And quickly, Donnell gets down in the count 0-2 with two away here in the second. Wagner checks his runners. And into the quickly, Donnell calls time just as Wagner's about to release the ball. Wagner again checks the runners and the pitch. Just a little low. Top of the second here at Holmes Field. Your Skippers lead 1-0. And Donnell sends one into right field for a base hit. That's going to bring up Logan Dolph for the Hushpuppies. Correction on that name, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be Logan Delph for the Hushpuppies. currently attending Cleveland Community College. Pops one up. And the play is made by Ryan Bellamy to retire the Hush Puppies before they end up doing any damage. And the River City Skippers would like to thank some of their corporate sponsors. Hopper Flow Controls here in Elizabeth City, Pine and Porch, as well as Farm Bureau Insurance, Miss Amy Robertson. Also like to thank Town Bank and Insurance, as well as Bear Garden for their support of Skippers Baseball. Starting the Skippers out in the bottom of the second is 22 Jalen Greenidge. And Jalen watches ball one come down from England on the mound. England gets his sign in the windup. Greenidge pops one up, foul. And it's out of play. I believe that just woke up everybody in the concession stand. And Greenidge sends one into shallow center field for a base hit. And with that, that's going to bring up number 16, Court Keegley, for the Skippers. Court, a sophomore out of Davis and Elkins College, comes to us from Quinton, Virginia. As the rain starts to come down just a little harder here at Holmes Field. Keegley sends one on the ground through the gap between first and second, and he is safely on board at first, and that advances Greenidge to third. And with that, that's going to bring up a newbie to the Skippers, number 2, Paxton Huff. Huff sends one down third base line, but rolls foul. Paxton takes one a little bit high, making the count 1-1. Paxton comes to us from Plano, Texas to hang out for the summer. England's pitch a little low and to the outside. Huff is currently attending University of Dallas as he swings and misses to even the counts, 2-2. England with the pitch. And Huff watches strike three come down the mound. That's going to bring up Joe Hertzler, number 9 for the Skippers. Hertzler shows bunt and is able to pick up ball one. Runners on first and third. One out for the Skippers. Hertzler takes another ball high. 2-0 the count. Rain is starting to ease off here at Holmes Field. We are so glad that you've decided to join us online. As Hertzler takes ball three. England checks his runners at first and third. And the windup. And Hertzler is able to get on board with ball four. That's going to load the bases up for Cole Wagner to come back to the plate.
Now batting number 8, Cole Wagner.
Cole Wagner watches strike one come down. And as soon as we say the rain was letting up, down it comes again. Wagner pops one up. And it bounces off the top of the first base dugout, which puts him way down in the count, 0-2. One away for the Skippers. Bases are loaded. Skippers are up 1-0 in the top of the second.
Next year.
As Wagner picks up ball one. Wagner sends one sky and into right field, shallow right. It does float foul. As several of the Hushpuppies tried to make a play, were unable to do so. England fires one in high and outside to even the count at two. England gets a sign and the set, the pitch, low and inside, ball three, even it makes the count full to Cole Wagner. And with that wild pitch from England, that's going to send Wagner trotting off to first. That brought in Jalen Greenwich for the score for the Skippers, and that's going to bring out Rob Shore to have a conversation at the mound. And Court Keatley's going to get in for the score for the Skippers on a wild pitch. England gets his sign and the wind up. Pop foul right above our heads here behind home plate. I think it made it to the fourth green there on Knobs Creek golf course. Delivery to Ott, it's going to strike him in the back, which is going to deliver him to first base. That's going to bring up number 18, Drew Nagel. Back to the plate, he's 0 for 1 for this evening. Bases are loaded top of the second. Your Skippers are ahead 3-0 over the Hushpuppies. And England gets a sign and into the stretch. Nagel fouls one back. And Nagel sends one to third base, where they're easily tags the bag for the end of the second inning. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, your score, the Hushpuppies 0, your Skippers 3, as the rain continues to come down here at Holmes Field. We've got some diehard baseball fans hanging out to check out Skippers Baseball. Your River City Skippers will have their next home game Thursday night and they will take on the Bogies from Sandhills. Game time 7 p.m. here at Holmes Field here in beautiful Elizabeth City, North Carolina. Starting out the third for the Hushpuppies is number 12, Carter Bass. Oh for one, last time up. As he watches the count get even, 1-1. Bass sends one flying out of play off the first base side. Sends yet another one just outside. First base line outside the fence. Somewhere in Knobs Creek. Wagner with the pitch, and it's sent to center field. where Paxton Huff is unable to make a play on it. That allows Carter Bass to make it safely to first. That's going to bring up 13, J.R. Langerfeld for the Hushpuppies. Wagner gets his sign after checking the runner. And it's going to be low and in the dirt. And Carter Bass is going to be easily able to make it to second on that wild pitch. Wagner gets the sign and pitch. Langerfeld sends one into left field where it's easily taken in by Cole Wagner for out number one. That's going to bring number 19, Christian Walker, back to the plate for the Hushpuppies. Nice play by Colby Ott, shortstop. Blasting it back to Ryan Bellamy at first for out number two. That's going to put the Hushpuppies two outs. The top of the third, nobody on. Correction. Runner on third. Missed him over there at third. As Willen takes strike one. Too many devices here going on. That's going to bring count to full to Eli Willen. Wagner gets his sign and set. And the pitch. And Willen takes it on the chin as he gets called for strike three. It's going to retire the side. Skippers are able to thwart a run from the Hushpuppies. That's going to make your score still. The Hushpuppies 0, your Skippers 3. again, a big thank you to some more of our corporate sponsors. Stevenson Sand Company, the Perry Auto Group here in Elizabeth City, Little Caesars Pizza, as well as Albemarle Fence Company. Thank you for sponsoring Skipper's Baseball. And starting off the bottom of the third for the Skippers is number 37, Ryan Bellamy. Let's see if Bellamy can get some traction for the Skippers. To start off the bottom of the third, Bellamy sends one foul to even the count at one. I think that ball just took a splash in the creek over there. Angling with the pitch. Low and away. Two balls, one strike. And the wind up, and it's way outside. 3-1. Bellamy sends a bullet into right field for a base hit. That's going to bring number 24, Jaden Greenidge, back to the plate. Checks Bellamy at first, and Greenidge sent one to Carter Bass at shortstop, where he is able to pick off Ryan Bellamy for out number one for the Skippers. And with that, that's going to bring up number 22, Jalen Greenidge. Jalen sends one up, which is easily brought in by Logan Sawyer for out number two. That's going to bring up number 16, Court Kegley, to the plate for the Skippers. Two away. He sends a hopper to third, and that's going to end the inning. No run scored on that at bat for the Skippers. Score remains 3-0 Skippers. And starting off the Hushpuppies for the top of the fourth is number 37, Caden Swain. And Wagner opens it up with a strike going by Swain. And the pitch from Wagner is popped up. And that is easily handled by Drew Nagel for out number one. That's going to bring back up number 22, Drake Carrick, for the Hushpuppies. Wagner's going to throw one low and into the dirt for ball one. Wagner with the windup. Of the count. Top of the fourth, 3-0 to score. Carrick's gonna watch strike one come in, make the count 2-1. He's gonna ground one to third, where Jaden Greenidge makes the play. Shoots a bullet over to first base to Ryan Bellamy for out number two.
Now batting number 29, Logan Sawyer.
That's going to welcome back number 29, Logan Sawyer, back to the plate for the Hushpuppies. Wagner fires in ball one, low and outside. And with that evens the count up 1-1. Wagner with the pitch. Sawyer with a grounder. Goes into shallow center field for base hit. That's going to bring up Cody Donnell.
Now batting number 9, Cody Donnell.
And Wagner starts the at-bat with a strike. Wagner checks the runner. And just like that, Donnell is down in the count, 0-2. As the rain steadily comes down at Holmes Field. Donnell comes back up and gets set. Wagner gets his sign, checks his runner, and the pitch. Donnell drills one outside, out of bounds, foul. To stay alive for the inning. and the 02 high and inside 1 and 2. And starting off the bottom of the fourth is Paxton Huff back to the plate for the Skippers. As he watches a ball come in for 2-1 as your count to Huff. And with that, Huff is going to take the trot to first as England hits him with a pitch high to the back. That's going to bring up Joe Hertzler back up for the Skippers. England with the pitch. Hertzler fouls one back to the net. And just like that, Hertzler gets down in the count, 0-2. And with that, that's going to retire Hertzler for this time around. That's going to bring back up Cole Wagner to the plate for the Skippers. 3-0 is your score, bottom of the fourth. One away for the Skippers. Runner on first. And Wagner watches ball one come down the hill from England. And the pitch low and in the dirt. 2-0 is your count to Wagner. Holmes Field starting to look more like a slip and slide every minute with all this rain that's coming down. Let's see if that has any effect on the outcome of this game. And the pitch from England. Wagner fouls one off. Well out of play on the third base side. And with that foul ball off the first base side, that's going to bring Cole Wagner with a full count. With one away. England with the pitch. Wagner's going to send another one foul. Still have Skippers diehards in the stands for tonight's game. And that's going to be low. And that's going to advance Wagner to first. Again, that's going to bring Kobe Ott back up to the plate. Kobe Ott batting 345 into tonight's game. Takes ball one. Runners on first and second. Ott bounces one down third baseline, foul to even the count at one. So And the pitch. Fired in for strike two on Colby Ott. England checks his runners. Ott pops one up. And England is going to make the play himself for out number two. Again, baseball fans, the Skipper's next home game will be Thursday night. Game time, 7 p.m., where your Skippers will take on the Sand Hills Bogies. And with that, that's going to bring Drew Nagel back to the plate. That's going to be a foul tip back towards the fence, and Nagel's bat goes flying down third base line.